and now WikiLeaks, secret cables, and the case against the soldier who allegedly took them. Ari Sreenivasan is back with our update.
Bradley Manning, the Army private at the center of the largest leak of state secrets in America's history, is to begin court-martial in June. He was arrested in May of 2010 while serving in Iraq and charged with stealing and sharing hundreds of thousands of classified government cables, many of which were published by the whistleblowing website WikiLeaks. Manning, who is 25 years old, faces 22 charges, including, quote, aiding the enemy, which carries a life sentence. A pretrial hearing concluded yesterday, and joining me now to talk about it is Arun Rath of PBS's Frontline and PRI's The World. He's been covering the Manning case from the beginning. So, Arun, this is sort of what sets the ground rules for what will happen in the trial, right?
Yeah, basically in these hearings, these pretrial hearings, they're basically arguing about the kind of arguments they can make in court, the parameters of the sort of arguments that Bradley Manning and his defense can make in terms of defending themselves against these charges. What's a little bit unusual about the hearings that we've been seeing so far is that they've turned into more of a bit of a dress rehearsal for the trial itself and for what might be his sentencing, actually, because his attorneys have already essentially admitted in their pleading so far that Bradley Manning is responsible for the leaks. So it's changed from a situation of the trial being, did he really do it, to yes, he did it, but here are the reasons why we think it doesn't rise to the level of being a crime.
And in these past couple of weeks, both sides, the prosecution and the defense, have had a few victories, or I guess setbacks, whichever way you want to look at it. So let's start with the prosecution. Yeah. What's been working in their favor?
Well, what's worked in their favor is just last night the judge ruled that motive cannot be considered here. The fact that Bradley Manning may have leaked these documents in order to do the right thing, that doesn't really matter. What matters is was he guilty of the crime on the merits? So that was a significant victory for the prosecution. That can't be entered into evidence.
So what about the defense? Is there anything that's worked in their favor over the past few weeks?
Not an awful lot, but there have been a couple of places where they've been given a little bit of ground, which I think they can take some heart in. One is that they will be able to introduce evidence that Bradley Manning was selective about the sort of information that he leaked, that he specifically tried not to leak information that would damage national security. The other is that the prosecution has to prove that Bradley Manning knowingly was providing information that he knew would get to the enemy, meaning al-Qaeda. Just leaking it to WikiLeaks is not enough, that it has to be proven that he knew this information would get into al-Qaeda's hands.
So I've been seeing some reports that the prosecution will try to present that some of this information was on Osama bin Laden's computer, or at least a request for it was. Why is that important?
Well, that's crucial to the biggest charge against Manning, which is aiding the enemy. And again, if they're trying to show that the evidence that these leaked documents got through to al-Qaeda, they're actually introducing this evidence, which was gathered apparently from the Abbottabad compound where Osama bin Laden was killed. These are apparently messages that came out from bin Laden asking for specific documents that were leaked in the WikiLeaks trove, specifically documents regarding the war logs of Iraq and Afghanistan. So they have these apparently from, you know, in bin Laden's own voice asking for these specific documents.
Okay, and there were also lots of different intelligence agencies who had done assessments on exactly how damaging this could have been to the United States, and we're hearing that that's not going to be admissible.
Yeah, and it's actually a sort of a peculiar thing because earlier the judge had ruled that the defense, Bradley Manning's defense, could have access to these documents. These are reports from these intelligence agencies where they assess how much damage was actually done by the release of these documents. They're classified and they're letting the defense look at them, but then they ruled just last night again that they cannot use these documents during the trial. They maybe can feature them during the sentencing hearing, but during the trial, they're allowed to look at them, but they can't bring them into evidence.
Okay, you've been in court. You've had the chance to see Bradley Manning a few weeks ago. What did he look like, and what impresses you about him?
I have to say, of all the people that have been called to the stand, Bradley Manning came across as the most appealing witness. He was, I wouldn't say charming, it's not sort of a traditional charisma, but there's something about the fact that he's a young, kind of geeky kid. He's a little bit awkward, and he comes across as a sympathetic character. He was talking about the ways in which he was held in Quantico in solitary confinement for 23 hours a day. And he talked about this peculiar, kind of a classic catch-22 situation where he would do these things during the day to keep himself sane, like talking to himself in the mirror or dancing in his cell as a way to break the tedium to keep himself sane. And at the same time, these things were used as evidence against him, as evidence that he was actually mentally unstable.
All right. And so this hasn't been a speedy trial. As we mentioned, he was arrested in 2010. How long does this go now? Does this actually start in June? Is there a possible plea agreement?
It's been delayed multiple times. So, you know, June is looking a bit more realistic because there's a lot of business that's needed to be taken care of that's happened in these hearings. It's possible there might be a plea agreement before then, but this is an issue now in the trial. They argued yesterday that Bradley Manning has been denied his right to a speedy trial. Traditionally, under military law, you're supposed to have a trial within 120 days, and Bradley Manning has been incarcerated for, we're in the third year now, over 1,000 days. The prosecution says that the reason for that is this is an extraordinary case. We have 250,000 diplomatic cables to go through to assess the damage here, that we need this time to go through it. But the defense says that, you know, this is a miscarriage of justice.
All right. Arun Rath of PBS's Frontline and PRI's The World. Thanks for joining us.
Thanks, Ari.